There's so many people in the world that are suffering and are challenged, and there are solutions for them that are going to be enabled by science.
My name is Hosea Nelson. I'm a professor of chemistry at the California Institute of Technology. We're trying to improve the human condition through our chemical research to contribute to the development of new therapies for disease. 70% of pharmaceuticals come from natural sources, like plants or bacteria or marine organisms. And so typically, trying to analyze all the chemicals, we'd be able to understand what 10 or 20% of them are. The technique that we've developed helps us to identify the other 80%. We're being recognized for our use of microcrystal electron diffraction, a technique termed micro-ED, and its use in characterizing small organic molecules. It will allow us to identify and characterize with atomic precision molecules that were uncharacterizable 3 years ago. There's sometimes small differences between molecules that dramatically affect what they can do. You can have two molecules with the same exact formula, and one could be a poison, and one could be a cure for a disease. And so we need that level of precision to make treatments. We have several collaborations with pharmaceutical companies where we've used micro-ED to solve structures with them. There's already been micro-ED structures included in new drug applications filed with the FDA. Our plan and our hope is that we're going to go around the world and understand what chemicals are in everything. And we kind of want to map the chemical universe. Being a Blavatnik National Awards laureate means a lot for me personally and professionally. I think being recognized for accomplishments validates many hard years of work. I think that my background is different than most scientists from socioeconomic perspective, racial perspective, cultural perspective, and I hope that I can serve as a role model and point of inspiration. Unrestricted funds in our research lab will allow us to pursue riskier avenues of research, and we really think that those are the sources of the biggest discoveries. We are going to uncover a whole new chemical world that we've been blind to for two centuries of doing chemistry.